Hey, what's up, my dudes? Today I've got another superconductor ring video for you. And now the story behind this ring is that I had a customer who wants a ring that's very similar, but made out of a different material. So I had the idea to do a practice of it first because I wanted to do that anyways in the first place, but I thought it would look really cool in superconductor. So I decided to experiment, do it with that. And then I figured why not turn it into a YouTube video as well. And I actually really do like the results, so I'll probably add it as an option to my website. And you'll see the end result. It's actually really cool. And this might be something I want to add to my website. It is actually a really time-consuming process, so it might not even be worth my time to offer these on there. But let me know what you think. Give me some feedback down below if you think it'd be worth it for me to throw it up on the website. If you guys are interested, I'll do my best to get it on the site. So first off, I'm cutting off a piece from my tilted superconductor rod. And I did think this ring would look much better with the tilted superconductor on there. So that's why you see me cutting off the tilted piece. It's not just because it was the easiest piece I had on hand. I actually do think that having the superconductor rods themselves sticking out at a bit of an angle after I etch this in acid, I think that's going to look really cool. So after a few minutes of cutting on the metal bandsaw, I'm able to cut all the way through and I've got this kind of skiwampus cookie shape here. And in order to fit this into my lathe jaws, I actually need to trim down those oblong edges. And so I'm just going to manually sand that down on my belt sander. I went through two sanding belts just on this step. So I definitely got the 10 pack of sanding belts ready to go just because I'm just going through these like crazy. Now you'll see I stopped before it's perfectly circled. That's okay. I just need it to fit in the lathe jaws. And then once I can get that hole drilled out in the center and then have it mounted onto the ring mandrel, then I can true it all up and make sure everything's smooth and flat and how it should be. So to bore it out, I'm just using this center drill. These are made specifically for lathes and they're just a really sturdy drill bit that you can just plunge straight into hard materials just like the superconductor, and they're really durable and they're able to cut through it like almost nothing else will. But that's not to say that it's not still a very difficult process to cut through superconductor. It's actually really difficult. The titanium in the superconductor makes it really hard to machine, and then also the copper surrounding it is incredibly hard to work with. It work hardens as you go, and it's also a really gummy material, so it's getting gummed up and also hardening and causing problems there. So you go through drill bits like crazy. I'm only going to get this one use out of this drill bit before I need to flip it around. And then I'll get probably one more use out of that on another superconductor piece, and this thing will be garbage. So superconductor is definitely a really rough material to work with. It uses up a bunch of tooling. Now that I've got the live center all the way through, I'm going to switch to a boring bar, and then I'm using the tungsten carbide bit on that. And then I'm continuing the process I started, so I'm just hollowing it out more and more until I can get it to fit on the ring mandrel. Now that I've got that hollowed out, I'm putting my expanding ring mandrel on the lathe jaws. And by the way, I get a lot of questions in the comments of where to buy these. You just go to bangleguy.com. He's got them on there. They're a really handy tool to have around the shop. And if you don't want to buy one from him, if you're tight on cash or something, you can easily make one yourself. It's a really fun lathe project. So if you're wanting to make rings on your lathe or you're looking for lathe projects, then why not make a ring mandrel? And if you're interested, let me know in the comments. I could post a tutorial on how to do that. I'm definitely no expert, but I'm sure I'd be able to manage and cut out a decent one of these. Okay, so I've got the ring blank on the mandrel, and I'm using my left-handed lathe cutter, and I'm just trimming down the outside diameter slowly, just about a half a millimeter at a time. And eventually I get through all the surrounding copper that goes around the superconductor filaments, and then I get to the part of the ring where it's mostly those superconductor filaments. And because I'm not making this ring for a specific person or purpose, I decided to pick and choose the pattern I wanted rather than the size I wanted. So I just cut into the superconductor until I saw a pattern that I thought was really cool, and then I will make the size according to the outside diameter. So it's kind of opposite most of the time. So this is an interesting ring. It was fun to make like that, but it did turn out to be a pretty big ring though. All right, now I've got the ring blank back in the lathe jaws, and I need to widen the inner diameter of it so it's not such a fat ring. Then once I've got that widened, I'm using my Dremel tool with a coarse sanding wheel on it, and I'm rounding out the edges so it has a nice comfort finish to it. And then you'll also notice that that lathe bit, if you're not really careful, and I wasn't super careful on this one, it can leave a really kind of gross smeared finish to the superconductor. So I'm also using the sander to grind that away and get a really nice clean surface finish on there. And then of course at the end I switched to a finer Dremel sanding wheel, and then I used that to clean up the inside and give it a smoother finish. But I'm going to take it a step further for this ring. I'm going to take it over to my sanding wheel and then put a whole bunch of bevels and angles all over this ring, and it'll give it what I call an obsidian finish to this. And you'll see I have this option on my website for some of the carbon fiber rings, as well as I used to do them for the Damascus steel rings as well. But the process is a little bit different for this. You can't hand forge that finish on there. And then for the carbon fiber ones, I like to use a Dremel wheel to do that because it makes the shape a little bit more interesting. But obviously with this superconductor, I wouldn't be able to do that. So you can see the process I'm using. It's fairly simple, but it's just very time consuming. I've got the sanding table set up and it lets me do a bunch of different angles on the ring. So all I do is I put about 3 to 4 bevels onto the ring. I just sand a flat surface onto it, and then I'll adjust that angle to be a bit more steep and then repeat the process. Obviously I'm flipping the ring 180 degrees a couple times throughout the whole process so that I get it even on both sides. And you'll see when I show it off on the camera how these steps progress. You can see it slowly transform from that normal ring look that we had to this really cool angular obsidian finish. All right, here that is. You can see it's got all those really cool faces to it. It looks really cool under especially multiple different light sources. It's got a bunch of different reflections that show off all those faceted edges, so I think it looks really cool. And this is a ring that I think will look really cool with a deep etch. So I'm etching it over the span of about 12 hours. So off camera, I just had it in here all day. I was just flipping it over every 30 minutes to an hour every time I'd think of it. And that was to make sure I got an even, consistent etch to it. But then once that was done, I pull it out and you'll see just how cool this thing turns out. We still have one more step to do, but this thing's looking great. So now I'm going to throw it into the rock tumbler. This will scrape away that reddish pinkish coating that the copper had over it. And then it'll also round away some of the sharper edges that this had. And I didn't have enough time to do this as long as I would have liked to for the video, just because I wanted to get this out sooner. So I only got it in there for a few hours, whereas after I post this video, I'm gonna leave that in there for about 4 days, and that'll make it a lot better. And it'll also help to hide some of the scratching from the sander that was on there. The reason that it had those scratches in it is because I'm waiting for some finer sandpaper discs to show up. But because this is a prototype, I figured it'd be okay for this one. So if you see those scratches and it kind of annoys you, just know I'm triggered too. I really wish I had some finer sandpaper discs for this. But who knows, maybe the rock tumbler will do a really nice job and end up hiding those all together. So we'll see. All right, and after pulling it out, this thing is finished. Definitely be sure to let me know what you think down in the comments. And now one thing that I noticed after filming this was that I actually didn't like the look of it on camera as much as I did in person. And I was trying to figure that out. And I think the reason for that was because doing it with all the soft lighting and video equipment that I had, where I try to get really even, consistent lighting. And that's good for most rings and most things. But that's not really where this ring shines. And I mean that literally, where it shines. And what makes it cool is all those different faceted edges that it has. So I actually took a video of it on my iPhone in just my living room. And I think that really shows off those edges a lot more than the studio lighting does. All right, guys, that's all I've got for you in this week's video. If you want to check out my website where I sell rings like this and, of course, many others, you can see that. There's a link down in the description. You can also go to my Instagram. That's a great place to see what's going on behind the scenes. And it's also a good place if you're looking for a deal on the website. That's where I'll post all the discount codes, anything like that. So be sure to follow me on there. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and I will see you in the next one. Thanks.